Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, and best wishes to all of us. Okay, let me introduce myself. My name is Ken Atanasky Paparapat with name 22045311145 from Mechanical Engineering of Udayana University. Okay, today we will talking about the 4.11 thermal transition of polymer, and then 4.12 design polymer structure for improved properties, and then 4.13 composite material incorporating polymer. So this is the reference that I use to make this presentation. Okay, 4.11 thermal transition of polymer. Polymer experience distinct phase transition when passing two specific temperature point. When temperature is raised, they physically transition from solid like glassy to rubbery. In the case of thermoplastic, is that from rubbery to liquid like a flow with additional heating. This transition take place in reverse when cooling. Thermal transition of polymer has K transition point, that glass transition temperature or TG, the temperature region where the polymer behavior transition from a hard glassy material to that of a soft rubbery material. Sudden loss in mechanical stiffness occur, and then melting temperature or TM, that the temperature point at which the polymer physically transition from a solid to viscous flow upon heating, or vice versa, from melt to a solid upon cooling. Whatever or not a polymer exhibit all of the illustrated transition, and whether they occur at a discrete temperature point or a temperature range is depend on the polymer molecule structure. Okay, I have a video about the thermal transition of gum atau permen karet. Let's watch this following video. Glass transition temperature of gum. So we take a sample for two. What happened to the gum? Polymer has a glass transition temperature above glass that material is heated, that are rubbery, and if cold, that they are brittle. 4.12 design polymer structure for improved property. Okay, design polymer structure for improved property has three principle that apply to give strength and resistance to a polymer. They are crystallization, cross-linking, and then the next one, increasing in hard stiffness of polymer molecule. Like you see in that figure, there is a picture of structure from plastic, resilient from rubber, and then a picture of crystallization, and many much more. Okay, 4.13 composite material incorporating polymer. Okay, by combining two or more material with complementary properties, a composite material can often be produced which is better than or even radically different from the component alone in terms of strength or resistance to heat or some other desirable quality. This principle of composite material has led to the design and manufacture of a new range of supermaterial with far-reaching effect on engineering and construction. The principal attraction of composite material is their superior combination of lightness, stiffness, strength, and ductility. Okay, let's watch this following video.
Hey dude, we know that metals and ceramics are strong but brittle. Polymers are weak but more ductile. What if we want a material with high strength and good ductility? Is there any material like that? Yes, of course, dude. We have a community of materials called composites, which have higher strength and flexible as well. As you asked, will let us know more about the composite materials. Basically, a composite is composed of two or more individual materials like metals, ceramics, and polymers. For example, a child's face cut and character may come from their parents. Like that, when we mix two different materials, the resulting material's properties will have the parent material's properties. For example, a ceramic material, glass fiber, and a polymer material, polyester. When we mix and produce a new material which comes as a fiberglass, which have more strength and more flexible also. So this is what we call a composite materials. Let us see some basic examples of composites. Wood and bone are some basic examples of natural composites, and synthetic composites are fiberglass reinforced polymers and carbon fiber reinforced polymers. So these are the examples. Let us see some applications of composite materials. They are used in construction. As we can see, concrete steel bars are reinforced in concrete for bridges and all. And then in energy, some windmill blades and other components are made up of composite materials. And in automobile, body parts of expensive cars, luxurious cars, and in sports applications also, and in aerospace application also, composite materials are used. Even in space applications also, composite materials are used.
Okay guys, I hope you have enjoyed this video. This video is also available in Tamil and Telugu, and the links of those videos given in the description. If you like the video, please like, share, comment, without forgetting subscribe to our channel.
Okay, thank you very much for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Shanti 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 Om.